So in this session, we will try to understand creating and using master pages. Or in this session, I will try to explain the step-by-step procedure required for creating and using master pages. By taking one simple example, let us say I got a requirement for creating a training institute website which must contain home.aspx page, and let us say the same website must contain .NET training.aspx page, and the home.aspx page must contain an header section, and inside the header section I just wanted to display the training institute's name, that is Pale University, and two phone numbers, one after the other in two separate lines. Similar way, in the footer section, let's say I wanted to display copyright symbol and then Pale University. And in between this header, I am calling this first portion as header and this last portion as footer. And in between this header and then footer, I just wanted to display some content about Pale University. Let's say I would like to include about Pale University as heading or subheading, and under this heading or subheading I just wanted to display some content, right? Maybe that is related to Pale University training. Similar way, I just wanted to create another page with the name .NET training.aspx. again, the .NET training.aspx page must contain a header, and in the header again I just wanted to display the training institute name, that is Pale University, and phone numbers. So whatever the phone numbers I have written in the home.aspx page, the same phone numbers I just wanted to display it over here, right? And a similar way, in the .NET training.aspx I need footer content, and inside the footer I just wanted to display copyright symbol and Pale University. In between this header and then footer, I just wanted to display some information related to .NET training. Maybe under the subheading about .NET training offered in Pale University, and maybe some content. So this is my requirement. So finally, I would like to create home.aspx and .NET training.aspx pages, something like this. Now, in order to create the home.aspx page content something like this, let's say in the home.aspx page, in the source mode, let us say I have written some code for displaying the header content, this header content. So let me call this code as code for header. And similar way, in order to display this body content, that is which is having about Pale University, let us say again I have written some code. Maybe I'll call this one as code for body inside the home.aspx page. Similar way, in the home.aspx, obviously we need footer, and let us say I have written again some other set of code for displaying the footer content, something like this. Maybe I'll call this one as code for footer. In the same way, even in .NET training.aspx page also we need the header content. So again, in .NET training.aspx, so again in .NET training.aspx I should write some code for producing the header content. Let me call this one as code for header. Apart from header, we just wanted to display some body content which must include about .NET training. Let's say I have written some code for body, code for producing body content. Similar way, even in the .NET training.aspx page also, let's say I have written some code for producing the footer content. Let me call this code as code for footer. So if you observe carefully, both the pages headers as well as footers, we can say that the content is same in both the pages. That is, header content as well as footer content is same in both the pages. So since the content is same in both the pages, obviously whatever the code we will be writing in the home.aspx page for producing the header in home.aspx, obviously we will be writing again same code in the .NET training.aspx page also for producing the same header content. Similar way, in the home.aspx page for producing this footer content, let us say we have written some code. Again, we will be writing the same code in .NET training.aspx page also for producing the footer in the .NET training.aspx. Right? So why the same code? The reason is simple. This home.aspx page footer content and .NET training.aspx page footer content is same, and hence we will be writing the same code. All what I am trying to explain here is this code as well as this code got duplicated, and similar way this code as well as this code got duplicated. Is it a correct approach to write the same code again and again in multiple pages? Obviously, code duplication is incorrect approach. Right? Now, my requirement is, I just wanted to avoid this content duplication, or I just wanted to avoid the code duplication in these two pages. So what I should do in order to avoid the code duplication? Obviously, we know that we must use master page for avoiding the UI duplication or UI content duplication. Right? Now, let me explain the solution for this problem. Now, what we should do here is, we should create a master page with the name maybe palle.master. Anyhow, you are allowed to give any name for the master page, but in my case I am assuming the master page name as palle.master. And inside this master page, whatever the repeated sections present in home.aspx and .NET training.aspx, that repeated content must be placed inside the palle.master page or inside this master page, right? Or in simple words, the header content and the footer content, or the code required for producing header and the code required for producing footer, must be placed in this master page. So in the master page, we should write some code for producing the header, and in the header we just need to display the training institute name, that is Palle University. And apart from this, in the header we have to display two phone numbers, one after the other. And similar way, in the master page, in the footer section, we should write the code for producing copyright symbol, and we should write the code for displaying training institute's name. Right? After creating the master page with header content and then footer content, now we should separately create a home.aspx page. Right? So we should create home.aspx page. Now I recommend you to forget about this home.aspx and .NET training.aspx, because this approach is incorrect. Right? So now what we should do here is, we should create home.aspx, and in the home.aspx, whatever the content we just wanted to display specific to home.aspx except this header and footer, that content we should place in the home.aspx. Obviously, inside the home.aspx, now we should write the code for displaying about Palle University, maybe heading or subheading, and some content under this. Similar way, we should create another page with the name .NET training.aspx, and in this .NET training.aspx, whatever the content we are displaying or whatever the content specific to .NET training.aspx, excluding this header and footer, this specific content we have to place in the .NET training.aspx, or in simple words, we should include about .NET training section inside this .NET training.aspx. After creating a master page and after creating home.aspx and .NET training.aspx. Now, if we can able to merge home.aspx page content in between the header section and footer section, in between this header section and footer section, whichever is created in the master page, if we can able to place this home.aspx page content in between header and footer, obviously the final output will appear something like this, right? So if this home.aspx page content is placed over here, so obviously the overall output will be appearing something like this, right? Similar way, if we can able to place a .NET training.aspx page content in between the header and footer content of this master page, that is in this area, if we can able to place .NET training.aspx page content in between the header and footer area, obviously the final output will be appearing something like this. Whatever the output we required in .NET training.aspx, finally we will be getting that output. So I believe you understood the point. Or in simple words, in the master page, while designing the master page, you try to include the repeated sections in the master page, and you try to create separate .aspx files with unique content, and that .aspx files content we have to merge it with the master page content for producing the final output. I believe you understood the point. Now, the next important point here is, in order to merge any .aspx file content into a master page requires a special control called as ASP content placeholder control. You must remember this point. The master page requires a ASP content placeholder control. Where exactly this control is required? The answer is simple. Into whichever the portion of the master page you want to receive the dynamic content, in that particular area you have to create ASP content placeholder control. So in case of this pale.master page, in between the header and footer, I just wanted to get the dynamic content. So here I wanted to get dynamic content. So in between this header and footer sections, I have to create ASP content placeholder control. Remember, ASP content placeholder control is capable of receiving dynamic content. I believe you understood the point. And you remember, depending on the requirement, we are allowed to create any number of content placeholder controls in a master page. In whichever the sections of master page you wanted to receive dynamic content, there you are allowed to create ASP content placeholder controls. I believe you understood the point. Now, apart from all these things, we should understand few more important points related to the .aspx files. The points are, or the point is, in order to merge any .aspx file content dynamically into master page or dynamically into ASP content placeholder control, the .aspx page must follow some rules. Let me explain this point one more time. In order to merge any .aspx file content dynamically into a specific location of master page, that .aspx file must follow some rules. Or if you can able to make .aspx file as a content page, then only you can able to merge the .aspx file content into master page wherever the content placeholder control is present. Or in simple words, every .aspx page must be converted into a content page in order to merge the .aspx page content into master page dynamically. Right? Now, let us try to understand the procedure required for converting a .aspx page into a content page. Remember, only a content page content we can able to merge dynamically into a master page. Right? Now, let me try to explain the rules required for making a .aspx page as content page. Maybe I can say rules for content page. Remember, if you want to make any .aspx page as a content page, the .aspx file must follow some rules. The first rule is .aspx file must not contain HTML, head and body tags. These three tags must not be present inside a .aspx file in order to make the .aspx file as content page. That is the first rule. And the second rule is, if you want to make any .aspx page as content page, the .aspx file must be linked with a master page. Or in simple words, every .aspx file must be linked with a master page in order to make the .aspx page as content page. Right? I believe you understood. Every .aspx page must follow these two rules in order to make the .aspx page as content page. I believe you understood these points.